Hello and Merry Christmas. This is Dan. And before we get into this year's Retro Hour annual Christmas super quiz, I just want to take a quick moment to give a massive thank you to you, our amazing listeners, for supporting us and being with us every week throughout 2022, as this is our final show of the year. Like we always do, we're taking the week between Christmas and New Year off, but of course we will be back with more incredible guests in the new year. And before we get into the quiz, just a quick reminder that the Retro Hour podcast is brought to you every week with our amazing friends at Bitmap Books. Now, quick question, did you ever manage a perfect landing on pilot wings? Well, you can check it out in their book, The Unofficial SNES Pixel Book. This gorgeous 272-page book chronicles the pioneering games of the 16-bit Super Nintendo. So you can check that out, treat yourself to a Christmas present, and the rest of their retro gaming books at bitmapbooks.com. And we thank them for their support throughout the year. Right then, on with this year's quiz.
Welcome to the annual Retro Hour Christmas quiz. It's the Ollie and Paul Takeover edition. My name's Paul Drury. I write for Retro Gamer Magazine and Edge, and I also co-host the Ted Dabney Experience podcast. And I'm joined by
Oliver Wilmot. I do a video games podcast at the Dice Cup here in Nottingham.
And we'd like to start by congratulating the Retro Hour team. We understand that you've just had a book backed on Kickstarter. I hear the working title is Legend Quest, Our Struggle to Finally Beat Ollie and Paul at a Video Game Quiz. That is going to be the title, we assume.
Well, we decided because we couldn't beat you guys, we'll just have you hosting the quiz this year. So that kind of solves
the
problem.
You did. Okay, well, it looks like you're playing this one for bragging rights between yourselves. Now, we know that one of the teams is Dan and Joe, but we understand that Ravi has actually brought in a ringer.
Mm. Yeah.
Is this true, Ravi?
Yeah, I've brought in the big guns today.
Miyamoto? Have you got
Miyamoto? No, I've got Mike Dailly. So if we do get a DMA Designs round, then
Dailly, wow. Cool.
Hello, Mike. Hello. We played your games. They're great.
Thank you.
I wonder if there'll be any of his games in the quiz.
I look forward to the Lemmings round there.
Actually, yeah.
Oh, wow. God, if we're right. Okay, anyway, this quiz is 9 rounds. We're going to alternate. Ollie's is going to be more traditional question-based ones.
Yes.
Mine in between will be, let's just say, a little bit more interactive. Mm. I'm going to be keeping score, possibly not as good as your wife, Dan, please. I've got a lot to live up to, I know. So it's over to Ollie for round one.
Right, brilliant. So, yes, we're going to start, of course, with round one. There's going to be 10 questions per round. And round one is about Sega and Nintendo.
Oh, questions. We got this, Joe. We got this.
Okay, so who are you going to ask first, Ollie?
Oh, that's a good point. I think I'll start with Mike and Ravi.
Mike and Ravi, okay.
Mike and Ravi, question number one. Describe the item in the Bomberman games that increases your movement speed. The little picture on the item.
I think it's a little pair of trainers. Sneakers, boots.
No, I think
we have to pass that over, I'm afraid.
Yeah, incorrect, I'm afraid. I'm going to pass it over to Joe and Dan.
Roller skates.
Yes, correct. It is roller skates.
Oh, these console guys.
Start as we mean to go on.
Okay, so question number two is for Joe and Dan. So this is a bit of a long one, so bear with me. I'm going to read out some text that's on the front cover of a Japanese Mega Drive game, but it is in English. I want you to tell me what game this is from. Don't just sit there and waste your precious time. When you want to do something, do it right away. Do it when you can. It's the only way to live a life without regrets.
I think I know this, Dan.
Go on, Joe, take it.
Is it Sonic?
Correct. Yes, nice one. So, next question is for Mike and Ravi. Question number three. Only compatible with 12 games. Name this peripheral required for Yoshi's Safari.
I think it's the Super Scope.
Correct. That's the right answer.
Well done. They're off the mark.
Cool. Okay. Back to Joe and Dan. Question number four. The Game Boy Advance SP was released in 2003. What is SP short for?
I think I know the first word. Do you think that might be right, Joe?
Yeah, go for it.
I don't know. Special?
Correct. It is actually the whole thing. It's just special. Nice. Yes.
Well done, Dan.
What a blag.
Nice one. Right. Next question is for Mike and Ravi. Question number 5. Mojo's Crunch is an unusual stage for X-Men for the Mega Drive. Which single button must you press to complete it?
No clue.
Yeah, this one's... I've drawn a blank.
Pick a button.
X-Men for the Mega Drive.
Select.
I'm afraid not. That's incorrect. I'll pass it over.
Go on, Joe.
Is it the reset button on the actual console?
Yes, that is correct.
What? What game has a reset button to complete a level? That's insane.
X-Men for the Mega Drive.
Wow.
No, no.
But unorthodox, I do.
It's like a trick question, that
one.
Yeah, it is a bit of a strange one. It's the only game where you have to do that. Right, next question is for Joe and Dan. It's question number 6. Do you remember the 2nd of February 1994? Which Bill Murray movie has a connection to the North American release date of Sonic the Hedgehog 3?
Do you think it might be that year? 94?
Might be. I thought that film was a bit earlier than that, but that's the only film I can think of that he's in from around that time, so go for it.
Is it Groundhog Day?
Correct.
Yes.
Love Groundhog Day, Hog, Hedgehog, get it?
Ah, yeah.
Oh, that's a stretch.
Yeah.
Are you going to now read that question again? Like, it's Groundhog Day?
Yeah.
I will still get it wrong.
For the rest of the whole show. Yeah.
Yeah, right. Just an hour of that.
Right, okay, Mike and Ravi. Question number 7. Name Nintendo's official wireless controller for the GameCube.
The Wave Bird?
Correct.
Well done.
Oh, wow, you're all doing really well. Joe and Dan, question number 8. In Super Mario Land 2, what item must you collect to change into Bunny Mario? Super Mario Land 2.
I'll let you take this one, Joe.
This is the Game Boy one. I'm pretty sure you got to collect golden coins, but that's not what... Is it a carrot?
Correct. Oh, wow. Okay. Mike and Ravi, question number 9. What Sega series are these subtitles from? Kiwami, Zero, The Song of Life, and Like a Dragon.
No, not a clue.
Zero Wing.
I'm afraid that's incorrect. I'll pass it over to Joe and Dan.
Is it Yakuza?
Correct, it is Yakuza.
Wait for the computer round.
Yeah,
I know. It's only because it's Sega Nintendo round, guys.
It's a good one to start with, Joe. I'm happy with it.
Yeah.
Okay. This is going to be the last question for this round for Joe and Dan. Question number 10. Which Sega Light Gun game spin-off requires a keyboard?
Oh, you know this, Dan.
Yeah, Typing of the Dead?
Well done, that's correct.
There we go.
Nice one, guys.
Wow, well, at the end of round one, out on Rainbow Road, we have Dan and Joe with 8 and stuck on Mario Circuit, Ravi and Mike with 2. But it can all change, can't it? Okay, so we're now moving on to round 2, and that means that we'll be starting with Dan and Joe. Okay, so this round is called Alt Text. What I am going to do is read out descriptions of 5 consoles or computers, just the physical appearance of the machine, and you have to guess the console or computer in question. So to give you an example, an easy example, if I said, it's purple, has 4 controller ports at the front, and is box-shaped, what might you guess, Ollie?
What?
Sorry, I've not even written that down because I thought you'd just know it.
I was not prepared.
So it's purple, wow. Has 4 controller ports at the front, and it's box shaped.
Oh, is it the GameCube?
Well done! Yay. Can I say that was very impressive acting there, because because it wasn't acting. Okay, right. So you have 1 minute. Can I also just say you can pass? Okay, and I will go on to the next one. Okay. So Dan and Joe, are you ready?
Yeah,
so,
this is computers or consoles, then it can be either.
And I will tell you whether it is for each one.
So do you read all five words at once, or is it like you read a word?
No, I'm just going, you'll see. Okay. I'm just going to, I'm going to discuss. You can shout as many times. So, okay, you know, it's not your first answer. It's as soon as you get it, I'll go correct and move on to the next one.
So it's kind of like a quick fire, but yeah.
It is. Okay. So Ollie, you press that to start the minute. So, and your time starts now. Okay. It is black. It has got PS2. A wood veneer at the front.
Atari 2600.
It's got a... Correct. Okay. It's a computer. It is mainly white. It's got a proper keyboard.
Amiga 500.
It's got a small, the nut that would fall from an oak tree on the top.
Acorn BBC Micro?
It's Acorn Electron? Correct. Okay, it's a console. It is square. It's black. It's got
Xbox.
Kind of feet.
PS2.
It's got 3DO. The letters R-E. Correct. Okay, it is a handheld. It has got two controllers on the left, like thumb pads. And on
Links.
The back, you'd see Bandai written on the back. It's a handheld.
Wonderswan?
You can play it sideways as well.
The Wonderswan is correct. Okay. Okay, so this is also a console. It's got wood veneer. It's got very unusual controllers that you hold in your fist with triangular controllers that twist. Stop. You can guess that. We'll give you one guess.
The ColecoVision?
That is a damn good go. I finished on a very difficult one. That was the Fairchild Channel F. But my word, that was impressive. That is 4 points
good
for
stuff.
Dan and Joe. Very impressive, okay? Right, Mike and Ravi, obviously the same rules, and as you'll see, they get progressively more difficult, as I hope that did. Are you ready, boys?
Yep,
let's go.
Okay, and your time starts now. It is grey. It has got a big eject button in the front, and you put cartridges in at the top.
Nice.
Is correct. Okay, it is a computer. It has got a proper keyboard. It's mainly white, and it's got a fire-breathing animal on the
Dragon.
Front. Any number?
Dragon 32.
Yes, correct. Okay, okay. It is a console, but it's based on a computer. It uses CDs. It's got you put the
Amiga
disc in from a
CD 32.
Correct. Okay, it is a handheld. It has got a thumbstick and two buttons, A and B, as well as options and start.
Atari Lynx?
No, it's got a thumbstick, which is important, and it's got the letters S, N, K on the front.
Oh, is it neo-geo handheld?
Correct, I'll give you that one. Okay, and the final one, it is white. It's got a compact disc that comes out from the front. It's got a weird controller that looks a bit like a boomerang.
Pippin, Apple Pippin.
Correct!
Yeah, nice!
with 1 second to go.
Nice, guys.
Okay. Can I say, very, very good, full marks there for Ravi.
Oh, I'm glad I bought Mike.
I don't want to rub it in. I don't want to rub it in, but you definitely needed those full marks. Okay, so no offense. So after two rounds, Hungry Horaces are Dan and Joe with 12 points, but it looks like Ravi and Mike have gone skiing with 7.
Okay, let's move on to round 3. This round is called PlayStation Platforms.
Oh,
I think I only cover PlayStation 1 and 2 in this round, though. Question number 1, a simple one. Name the final boss in the original Resident Evil. Oh, sorry, what team is this
for? I was going to say, who's this for?
This will be Ravi. Yes. Yeah.
Ravi, yeah, Mike and Ravi.
Ravi or Josh. Yes, it's Ravi and Mike to start on this
Ravi,
round.
Yeah. Final boss of Resident Evil 1.
Oh, no, God, no. I'm not sure, Mike. Are
no.
you?
No. I've never played it.
A big zombie. Jeremy Beadle.
I take that.
I think that was on the Dreamcast.
Really close, but incorrect, I'm afraid. I'll turn it over to Joe and Dan.
It's the Tyrant.
Correct.
If you'd have got that wrong, Joe, I'd have been better.
I know.
Yeah, that's your specialist one, isn't it?
Yeah, I think I remember you're into that series. Okay, Joe and Dan, I've got question number 2 here for you. Who is the main character in most Oddworld games?
Oh.
Abe?
Yeah.
Say again, son.
Abe?
Correct. I'll move straight away on to Mike and Ravi's question number 3. It was the last Tomb Raider developed by Core Design and the first Tomb Raider on the PlayStation 2. Name this critical flop.
Tomb Raider, The Last Revelation.
I'm afraid not. That's wrong. I'll pass it over.
Oh, did you know that, Mike?
No.
Can you repeat the question again for us? Can you repeat it again for us?
It was the last Tomb Raider developed by Core Design and the first on the PlayStation 2.
Yeah, I think it might be that, Joe.
Which one? The last one? Or?
Yeah, the last one, yeah.
Angel of Darkness?
That is correct. Yes. So, Joe and Dan, question number 4, not including the D-pad analog sticks. Had to put this in here. How many buttons does the original PlayStation 2 joypad have?
Now, right. Joe's been counting these around his gaming den.
Right, so you've got triangle, square, circle, and X is 4. The L and R's are 4. But then you've got start and select and the analog button, which is another 3. And then you can click in the analog sticks because they're R3 and L3. Did you say including or not including the D-pad?
Not including the D-pad and analog sticks.
Not include. Okay. Well, the analog sticks are. You can click them in. So now I'm.
I'm not including.
Don't count
that.
Them.
Okay. Though.
So, how long are they taking on
11,
this question?
11. 11.
You're running out of time. 11.
Timer.
11. If you're including the analog.
Correct.
Button.
That is correct. Oh, I'll give you that one. God. Well done. I
just literally count of mine in the room.
I'm really impressed because the button, the analog stick button, was the one I thought everyone would forget about.
R3 and L3.
Not RJ.
Right, so Mike and Ravi, question number 5. The Fallen King, The Sands of Time, and The Two Thrones belong to which game series?
Prince of Persia.
Correct.
Well done, boys.
Question number 6 for Joe and Dan. The Beautiful Joe series, Okami, and God Hand were developed by which Japanese studio?
I know this one, Dan.
Go on, Joe, take it.
Capcom.
I'm afraid not.
No, studio. Studio.
Oh, not studio.
No publisher.
Capcom. I'll pass it over to Mike and Ravi.
Fair enough.
Square?
No, I'm afraid not. That's not right. The answer was Clover Studio, who are made up of ex-Capcom staff. So I can see you were close there.
Yeah, he's on Marvel vs. Capcom as well. So, but yeah, fair enough.
Yeah.
Right, so next question is for Mike and Ravi. Question number 7. Completing Challenge of the Gods in the original God of War unlocks a skin. Which farm animal does this allow Kratos to dress up as?
A pig?
Yeah. no.
I was going to say
that's the
as well.
Wrong answer.
That game just used to make me feel sick, God of War, when I played on it. Motion sickness.
And I will point out this is the original one, the old one. I'll pass this over to Joe and Dan.
I've got no idea either, but shall I have a guess, Joe?
Yeah, I think it. Well, I think my guess is. Yeah, go for it. Whatever.
Okay, if you think you might know it, go for it. I was just going to say. Random.
A chicken?
That answer is incorrect. He dresses up as a cow, believe it or not.
Nice.
I was going to say sheep, so I would have been close.
I don't think you'd see that in the modern version of the game. Right, next question is for Joe and Dan. Question number 8. Heavily influenced by Sega's Crazy Taxi, which Simpsons game was released in 2001?
Yeah, go on, Joe.
Road Rage. Simpsons Road Rage.
Correct! You knew that one. That was quick. On to question number 9 for Mike and Ravi. What group of peaceful pedestrians must you run over in Grand Theft Auto to get the Goranga bonus?
Panic listeners.
Correct.
How did you know that?
It's amazing. It just came to me.
We need a question about a game that we made now, Joe. Can we have made any?
And I was going to say football hooligans. I'm so glad I've got Mike.
Right, let's move on to the final question for this round. Number 10 for Joe and Dan. In 1997, a Polyphony Digital PlayStation racing game was released. And in 1998, the Cardigans released an album with the same name. What was this title?
Any ideas, Dan?
I think of Cardigan songs. A Race Rewind?
Incorrect. I'm afraid I'll have to pass it over to Mike and Ravi. It's the actual album name. By Polyphony Digital.
Need for Speed?
Oh, no, I'm afraid not. The answer was actually Gran Turismo.
All right.
Oh, wow.
Polyphony Digital.
Yeah.
That's the end of that round.
Okay, and at the end of round three, the Ravi and Mike are the liquid snakes with 9, but the solid snakes with 17. Damn,
kill me now.
Get used to it, Mike. This is exciting. Unseen Ravi.
Hey. Okay, so on to round 4. And the title of this round is Only Connect. Only Connect. Do you see what I did there? Okay, so what's going to happen is I'm going to give you 3 gaming-related things, and you have to tell me what comes next in the sequence. You can ask for a clue, and I will tell you the category or some other kind of clue to make it a little bit easier. You get 2 points if you can get the answer without a clue and 1 point with the clue. We will do bonuses as well, and the same scoring arrangements stand. Now, can I just point out, it is supposed to be based on the popular quiz show Only Connect. So I think these are hard. We will give you some reasonable time, though if it gets ridiculous, we will put the timer on, okay?
I've never heard of Only Connect.
No, I
thought it was going to be an Xbox Connect.
It involves you knowing stuff, but not about games.
I thought it was Xbox Connect as well. I was like, oh, God.
Don't worry. It's harder than University Challenge, Joe.
Absolutely. Right. Oh, man. So, yeah, this is quite odd. But anyway, so we're starting with, I believe it's Dan and Joe. Is that right? Yeah. That's right. Okay. So I'm going to alternate between you. So first, Dan and Joe, you've got team 1. Are you ready?
Yep.
As ready as we'll ever be.
Cherry, strawberry, orange. What comes next?
Is it a raspberry?
It isn't a raspberry. Now, can I go over to Mike and Ravi? Now, they haven't used the clue. You can use the clue, or you can have a go for 2 points.
Can we use the clue, please, Bob?
Yeah, although I think you'll probably go, when I say it's the first bonus fruit in the original Pac-Man arcade game, that might not be a brilliant clue. But yeah, so it's what fruit comes on screen 4 after the orange? After the orange.
Apple?
Is the right answer. Yay! Very good. Just 1 point, I'm afraid, there. But yes, very good. Okay, so it... Mike and Ravi, is your question now. Okay, so here we go. Tomb Raider, 1996. Tomb Raider 2, 1997. Tomb Raider 3, 1998. What comes next in that sequence? And I will tell you... No, I'll stop there. I'll tell you stuff if you ask for a clue.
Is it the last revelation?
Yeah, can I say you managed to get this one earlier. Right, last round. Okay, you're absolutely right. They were the first 4 Tomb Raider games in the main series, and Tomb Raider The Last Revelation was released in 1999 for the PlayStation and the PC. Well done.
A 2-pointer. Well done. Yes.
Very good. Okay, so now we're back to Dan and Joe. Okay, here we go. Sonic the Hedgehog, 1991. Sonic the Hedgehog 2, 1992. Sonic CD, 1993. Next in the sequence, please.
You've got this, Joe.
Sonic 3, 1994.
Sorry, that's not the right answer.
Wait, what?
Let's go over.
Sonic CD. Oh, I know what it is.
Well, it's... So, Ravi and Mike, what is the next? And you know that it isn't Sonic 3.
Sonic and Knuckles?
I'm sorry. Whilst you don't get any points, what do you... It's Sonic Chaos.
Chaos. God.
What, for the Game Gear?
Yeah, Sonic games in order of release, only counting distinct new titles, not 8-bit versions of a 16-bit
distinct
original.
New Sonic Chaos? What was that on?
I think it was a handheld.
It was on the Game Gear, and it was on the Master System, I believe.
Oh, I thought you said not including 8 bits. Oh, you said including.
No, I've already. Got you. I've just given you some clues. That was the clue that you would have got.
Oh.
So, no points.
Got you.
No points for that one. Okay, so now we are moving over to Ravi and Mike, okay? Astro Battles, Laser Attack, Galaxians, with an S at the end. 2 points if you know it, or you can ask for a clue.
Do you want to go for that, Mike, or should we ask for a clue?
Galaga?
I'm sorry, that's not the correct answer in the sequence. So over to Dan and Joe.
Well, Dan just sent me that answer, yeah. So...
Can you say it for us one more time? Give us it one more time.
Yeah. Astro battles.
Yeah.
Laser attack. Galaxians with an S. What's the next in the series? You haven't had the clue yet.
I was going to say, should we take our clue here?
Yeah, take the clue, yeah.
Okay. These are the first four levels of the arcade game Gorf. So you've got the first three. We're looking for screen four.
Have you ever played Gorf before, Joe?
No, I've never heard of it.
Oh my God. There's no resistance to this one.
I haven't actually heard of it either.
Thank you, Ollie.
Wasn't he Wayne's best friend in Wayne's? Yeah.
Yes, we really are not worthy.
I've got no idea on this.
Let's no idea whatsoever.
Space Invaders.
Can I just say you're surprisingly close? Space Invaders was actually Astro Battles, which is the first one. But no, it's Space Warp.
Oh.
Gorf, which of course you know because you should know your history, Gorf. Is the first. It's the first game really with distinct different screens in. Plus, it's arguably the first game to have a final boss, which is on screen five. Sorry, no points there. We're going to move back now to that will be Dan and Joe. Here we go. Harmless. Mostly harmless. Poor.
And can we not have any more clues? Have we used up?
No, you can have a clue for each round. 2 points if you get it without a clue. You can ask for the clue, and then you'll get 1 point.
I don't know about you, Joe. I think I might need a clue.
I think they're difficulties in a game. But I think we'll go for the clue, yeah.
Sorry, say it one more time, sorry.
Harmless. Mostly harmless. Poor.
Oh, they're scores. I think they're scores in a game. You know, like at the end of a level or something. Should we go for a clue, Dan?
Yeah, let's have a clue.
Okay, you actually was kind of on the right lines first time there, Joe. It's the combat rankings for Elite on the BBC Micro. So you've got harmless, mostly harmless, poor. I did say these were difficult.
Should we go for that? I've just sent you down.
Yeah.
I'm going to actually give you an extra clue in that this is the middle ranking. Do you think that might help?
Yeah, go for it.
Average.
Congratulations. Oh, I thought that was genuinely difficult. Okay, yes.
We were going to say normal.
Yeah, normal. After that, it became above average, competent, dangerous, deadly. Yeah. And of course, the final one,
Elite.
Okay, so now we're going over to Ravi and Mike. And can I just say that this one's, whilst this one isn't very retro, but it has got a retro link. So are you ready?
No.
Okay. No. Right, okay. Here we go. So here's the sequence. Marco Reus, Cristiano Ronaldo, Eden Hazard.
We'd like a clue, please, Bob.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so these are the most recent cover stars on FIFA games. FIFA, of course, has been going since the early 90s, but I agree that these are the most recent ones. So it's basically who is on the current cover of the FIFA games. Now, I know you two are good sporting lads. You know, you might have even watched the World Cup, recently. No.
There's been a World Cup on.
Don't get out, these boys.
Lionel Messi?
Get out. I say that's very unlucky. It is not Lionel Messi, so I can
only other one I know.
For 1 point because you've had the clue, Dan and Joe. Do you want to have a go?
Lionel Richie.
These boys really need to get out.
Looked a bit like he had hair like an 80s footballer, though, didn't he? To be said.
So Dan edits a football sports cast.
Really poor.
Joe works for a sports company.
Scored a hat trick in the World Cup final, and you cannot.
Mbappe. What's his name? Mbappe.
Mbappe, we'll give it. But I'm sorry, that was too late.
Fair enough.
He went to Lionel Richie. I think he used to play left back for Brentford, didn't he?
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
Okay, so let's go over. No points on that. Okay.
Mbappe from
let's
Eastlanders.
Go over now. Cheers. Thank you. We're going over to question four for Dan and Joe. Okay. Chop chop, Master Onion. Instructor Mussolini. Prince Flea Swallow. Jeez. Who comes next?
I know what game it is, but I ain't got a clue.
Is that lunch order or something?
Can I just say it was difficult to get this far in the game?
For us as well.
As it's proving.
Must be the hardest questions we've ever had on this.
Correct. Well, it is called Only Connect. You see what I'm trying to keep that... hardness there.
I know what game series it is, and I really want to blurt out what game series it is, but I feel like that's going to give the clue away to Ravi. So
can we have a clue here? I think we need it, Jeff.
They're going to say it's what.
This is one of the examples because I recognise how hard this is. The clue will help you. So yes, that's correctly identified. Those were the first three rappers in the original Parappa the Rapper game. You need to do number fourth, but I'm going to help you a little bit. The fourth, which is the one you're looking for, is set on a TV cookery show with Parappa following along at home trying to make a cake. And again, if you close, I will give it you.
Honestly, I don't know.
No.
I played Jammy Lammy a lot more than I ever played Parappa.
Something cooking?
Well, you like your guitars, don't you, Joe? You like your guitars.
Nah, pass on that. No idea. Know,
sorry.
Mike and Ravi, would you like a go? It's on a cookery show.
Was it the gherkin?
Oh, I thought he was going to say it.
The gherkin?
No. The gherkin head.
No, I mean, I don't know if that's a gherkin in the background. I can't remember that. What have you been smoking, Ravi?
It was the 90s.
I knew there was lots of vegetables.
Lots of weird stuff. It was actually Cheap, the cooking chicken. I would have accepted chicken.
I never got that far, yeah.
That is pretty hard. Okay, so now we're over to Ravi and Mike. Okay, you ready? Mario Circuit 1. Donut Plains 1. Ghost Valley 1. What comes next?
I think it's obviously Mario Kart levels, isn't it?
Yeah.
There was that... Well, don't take this as an answer, we're discussing. There was that there was that we'll beach one, and then there was Rainbow Road, but I'm sure Rainbow...
I have no
idea
what they were called, though.
Rainbow Road was a bit later, wasn't it?
That was the last one, yeah.
Yeah.
It was like 7 or something.
So it's no a cheap, is. Cheap one as well, wasn't there?
I have no idea. Yeah.
Can we get a clue?
Yes. Okay, and this is the clue. You were right. There are the Mushroom Cup circuits in Mario Kart on the SNES, and the one you're looking for has an internal element. It's not all of it. Most of it's inside. Might that help?
Yeah.
No idea the name of it, though.
Yeah.
Not a clue with the name.
Bowser's Castle?
Is that?
We knew that one.
That was all Mike.
We said it. Me and Dan said it. But yeah, well done, guys.
Very good. Respect you. Very good. Right. So the final one for Dan and Joe on this round. I've tried to link them so they're similar in terms of difficulty, and I think this is... Here we go. Grassland. Desertland. Waterland.
Well, let me just message this to Dan. Should I go for that?
You don't want a clue? You're going straight for it?
Fireland?
No. Okay, so Ravi and Mike, you can have a go or you can ask for a clue.
Yeah, we'll take the clue. Yeah. Please, Bob.
Okay, so those first three were the first three worlds in Super Mario Brothers 3. You're looking for the fourth one, and let's just say you wouldn't expect to find small things here. Too late now, my friend.
Giant Land?
Is the right?
Hey, good one.
Nice one, guys.
Mike is he's over the moon there. Right. The final one for this round is again for Ravi and Mike. Okay, are you ready? I think this is hard. Chariot. Hanged Man. Hermit.
Can we get a clue on this?
Yeah.
Was that Hanged Man or Hanged? Like, as in hanging?
Hanged as in, Hanged Man. I will definitely give you the clue. Okay, so those were the first three bosses in the first House of the Dead game. So you're looking for the fourth boss. When awoken, this boss utters the rather worrying phrase, "Who are you? Nobody gives me instructions. I shall destroy everything." Let's say that he might use possibly a wand to do that.
Wizard.
Don't give it in.
It's the wrong answer.
Joe knows this
but
one.
But that's a bonus for Dan and Joe.
It's the Magician.
It is the Magician. Well done. I sense you knew that without the wand. As well.
Yeah.
So well done. Well done. Okay. Well, can I say that was rather good? So let me just tot up there.
Yeah. Too much Harry Potter for me. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we've got Ravi and Mike, mostly harmless on 14, with Dan and Joe, dangerous Dan and Joe, out in front on 19. So let's just say that's brought it a lot closer.
Yeah, yeah. Cool. Brought it back a little bit.
A lot closer.
Brought it back a lot.
I wish I had a stronger drink than 7-Up now on my desk after that.
Okay, over to you,
Ollie. Shall we move straight on to round 5? Round 5 is all about Xbox and PC games.
Oh, come on, Dan. Jeez.
And it's going to be, the first question is for Mike and Ravi. Name the only Panzer Dragoon title released for the Xbox.
Oh, don't take this as an answer, but there was Saga, which was the first one. And then there was the Xbox one later, I think. Okay. You haven't got a clue. We'll go.
I have no idea.
Legacy.
Legacy
Panzer Dragoon Legacy.
The wrong answer, I'm afraid. I'll pass it over to Joe and Dan.
Is it Panzer Dragoon Orta?
That's the right answer.
Oh, go on.
So, question 2 is for Joe and Dan. Blinks the Time Sweeper can control time with his vacuum cleaner. But what type of animal is he?
I think I know this. I've asked him.
Yeah, I think you might be right.
Is it a cat?
That's the right answer.
I thought it was one of those assistants like Siri.
Question 3 is for Mike and Ravi. Bernard receives a letter at the start of Day of the Tentacle informing him that one of his tentacle friends has mutated into an insane genius. What colour is this tentacle?
I'll
give you a little clue because it's actually his name as well.
Yeah, it's a 50-50 one, but I think Mike's got it here.
Yeah, purple tentacle.
Pardon?
It's the right answer.
Purple tentacle. Yes, that is correct. Purple, excellent. Okay, moving back to Joe and Dan. Number 4, name the unit of currency used in the Sims and SimCity series.
Simoleon.
That's yes, not the Simoleon right pronunciation of it, though.
Rico, come on, Rico.
Yeah, that's not. It's Simoleon.
Would you like to give us the correct?
Yeah, Simoleon.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's yeah.
You got it. I think that was close enough. Wrong.
Yeah. Mike and Ravi, question 5. What type of nut or tree did Peter Molyneux claim you would be able to plant and grow in Fable?
Oak tree?
Yeah, acorn, that's correct. Yeah. There's an acorn or oak, oh, not oak tree. That's the right
Are you
answer.
Telling me that Peter Molyneux promised something in a game and it didn't actually appear? Is that what you're saying, Ollie? That's, okay. That's weird. Okay. Well done.
Well done. Joe and Dan, question 6. Which Canadian video game developer created Baldur's Gate, Neverwinter Nights, and Jade Empire?
Have you got any guesses, Dan, or...?
Should we give them 10 seconds? 10 seconds to go?
Okay. Yes, let's use that timer.
Should I just answer
say that?
That's the wrong answer. I'll pass it over to Mike and Ravi.
Forgotten Realms.
That's wrong as well. The answer was actually BioWare.
I've got a copy of it in my hand. There was BioWare.
Isn't that cheating?
There was Forgotten Realms as well. And then it was re-released by Atari.
If you can run around your house and find the answer, I think that's allowed.
Give me 10 minutes. I'm just going to run up into Joe's
house. Challenge Annika. Yeah. Go and find the SNES. Right. Okay,
question 7 for Mike and Ravi. GLaDOS from Portal is a reference to Microsoft DOS. In both cases, what does DOS stand for?
Oh, come on. Disk Operating System.
That's correct.
Said it rather beautifully as well.
Nice one. Joe and Dan, you've got question number 8. British games developer The Bitmap Brothers used to have their own publishing company. What was it called?
Bitmapsoft?
No, I'm afraid not. I'll have to pass it over to Mike and Ravi.
Bitsoft.
No, it's not. They were called Renegade Software.
Oh, of course, yeah.
Bloody hell, yeah.
Okay, so next question is number 9 for Mike and Ravi. Geometry Wars Retro Evolved was a hit on the Xbox 360, but which original Xbox game had the first Geometry Wars hidden inside of it? I'm going to give you a bit of a clue as well. It's actually a sequel. It's got number 2 in the title.
Mike, do you know anything about Geometry Wars?
I do, but I can't think what it was in.
I know of the title. But yeah. So it was like a game that was included inside another game?
Yes, that's right.
Okay.
I can't think what it is.
Before Xbox 360. 10 seconds
Battle
to go.
Battlezone.
Battlezone, no, I'm afraid not.
There was a version of Battlezone.
Do you want to say that, Joe?
So I'll move it over to pass it over to Joe and Dan.
Project Gotham Racing 2.
Yes, that's the correct answer.
What?
Dan actually got that. He sent it to me, but because of how he said it was the number 2, I was like,
all right, yeah, I knew it was one of them. I didn't know which one.
Wow. Yeah.
I thought it would be a bit unfair.
You thought it would be harsh to make you get the sequel.
Okay, so the final question for this round, number 10, for Joe and Dan, which artificial intelligence construct has the serial number of CTN0452-9 in the Halo universe?
Oh. Cortana.
That's the right answer.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
Congrats, that's the end of the round.
Okay.
I'm gonna still question that Never Win Nights question. Like, yeah.
Who do you think you are, Paul, when he's on a team?
I'm always a very good loser.
We can discuss
but
that.
But then so I don't usually lose, so it's quite easy to lose. Okay.
But we can quickly have a look into that. So I was saying it's BioWare. You were saying it was who?
Forgotten Realms, which were the big one for it.
To be honest, I thought it was BioWare. But I tell you what, if you lose by 1 point, which is really likely, then we will go back and have a stewards inquiry.
Okay.
But at the present moment, at the end of 5 rounds, our Master Chiefs are Dan and Joe with 24, and our Kane and Lynchers are Ravi and Mike on 17. Okay, we're now moving on to a very interactive round, which we did when Ollie and I hosted the quiz last time. And it seemed to go quite well. So we're doing it again. It's called Single Word Campaign. So what we're going to do is message each of you individually a game. And you have to give clues to your teammate using single words. If you manage to get it after just one word, you get 5 points. If it takes 2 words, 4 points, and so on. Now, here's an example convincingly acted out by myself and Ollie. So here we go. So I might look at my screen and go, okay. And I'm going to go with Ollie. I'm going to say ghosts.
Oh, that's obvious. It's really easy. Luigi's Mansion.
No.
What?
Dots.
Pac-Man?
No. Bow.
Oh, Ms. Pac-Man.
Is the right answer, and Ollie would get 3 points.
Yay.
Are they all that easy? Just checking.
No. Yes. Well, of course, this depends on how easy you make them.
Are we actually going to recognise the game?
I'm glad you thought that was easy, Dan.
So I think, again, I keep trying to work out who starts my rounds. Oh, so it must be Joe and Dan who's starting. So, Dan, I am now sending you your game. Okay. All I want you to tell me is if you have got it. Oh, and one last thing is that you are not allowed, when you use your single word, you are not allowed to use any word in the actual title, including part of that word. So, for example, if you were given Tomb Raider, you couldn't say raiding. That would be cheating, wouldn't it, Dan? And you'd never do such a thing.
You'd just say boobs.
Well, actually, that would have been quite a good clue. But thank you. Okay, so Dan, I have sent yours. Have a think.
Okay.
Let's see if you can get it on just one word.
Okay.
Remember, this is just for your team member, Joe.
Okay, Joe. I've got five then, yeah? 5 or 10.
Yeah, but if you can get it on one, you get 5 points.
People.
I mean, there's one or two games out there with people in them.
Really?
I'm going to go for The Sims.
Go on.
Oh my god!
Far too easy, that one.
Unbelievable.
That was excellent.
Wow, yeah.
What a clue then, eh? What a clue. I didn't know.
Taking the piss out of Dan's people. Clearly, that's all it needed. Okay, so now we're going over to Ravi. Okay, so Ravi, yours is being sent over now.
Maybe that's the only game with people in it.
Maybe.
I've received it.
The only game with people in ever. Okay, so have a think, Ravi, and you're giving clues, of course, to Mike.
Zombies.
Well, there's only one game that features zombies.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
They're very unusual in video games.
There's lots of zombie games. House of the Dead.
Shooting.
Why are you laughing? Game.
Shooting zombies. Seems
that's all of them.
To feel quite open.
That's it on your hands, Joe. Don't say it.
Stars.
Stars.
That's a good clue.
That's a good one.
You
could have said it in a voice.
Veronica.
Could have said it in a voice.
Oh, I recognise that, but I can't think what it is.
PlayStation.
No. I like how he read out his clues.
Yeah, no, not a clue.
And we're not going to pass these over as bonus.
Oh, come on.
No, because there's anyone. So,
no, not a clue.
Yes.
Dogs.
What is it? No, you stop. would you like to say what the
it was Resident Evil.
Not
Resident
nice.
Evil. Resident Evil was indeed. Yes.
I wish you say there's only one zombie game.
He did actually say in like the second round, Mike did say he's never played Resident Evil.
Resident Evil I thought he was aware of the general. I'm not changing it at this stage. Okay, Joe, it is yours.
Okay.
And, sorry, I've just laughed that I've actually typed in your own name, which, sorry. So let's actually give you a game. So yeah, you nearly just got Joe Fox, which
nice.
I would never have got that one.
Sound like a Mega Drive platformer, to be fair. So, okay. Here comes yours, Joe.
Oh, you're not allowed to name characters, are you?
You do whatever you want. As just long as you title. Don't use any word in that.
Gilius.
Golden Axe?
Yeah.
Oh, geez. These guys.
Nice and quick.
Gilius Thunderhead.
These guys.
I think okay. Having very best good. Friends five on the other team, yeah. You know, there's an advantage there.
Make sure it's a game
do
I actually
live
know.
Together, like the monkeys. Is that what the retro hours like? Okay, so for the final one is our special guest, Mike.
Please be a
so,
game I actually know.
Or made.
I'm not sure. You may or may not, I'm not sure.
Yes.
Okay, so can you... Away you go.
Granga.
Grand Theft Auto.
Oh, can I say strategic use there of yes, very, very good.
That was an unintentional okay. crossover there.
Absolutely.
I was going to pick a really weird Hare Krishna title.
okay, so at the end of round six, Jill Valentine's out in front, or Dan and Joe with 34, Barry Burton's Ravi and Mike with 22.
Oh, oh.
Got a bit of catching up.
How many rounds we got? Come on, bring the Amiga round on.
Oh, did you say Amiga? It's kind of an Amiga round. This round seven is called Arcade and Amiga.
Ooh.
So, the first question is to Mike and Ravi. Question number one, name the recurring pirate villain in the Secret of Monkey Island series. Pirate villain. Pardon?
LeChuck.
Correct. So that's the right answer.
Yeah.
Nice one. Joe and Dan, question number two. You are a blue bird who must gather all the chirps and bring them to safety to the exit. Which Sega game am I describing?
Flicky.
That's correct.
Never heard of that.
Nope.
Question number three for Mike question is okay. and Ravi. Question number three. Which game developer created Fusion, Flood, and Psycho Santa for the Amiga?
Oh. Yeah, go for it.
Was it Bullfrog?
That is the correct answer. Oh, yeah. Good one. Question number four is for Joe and Dan. In the original Lemmings, which skill is between the miner and the Portuguese?
Oh, come on. Okay, between the miner. Okay, actually, between the miner, do you count? I don't know if you count this. Is the nuke a skill?
It is. I would count that, but it's not that. That's not the right answer. I will pass it over. I'm gonna
say it to get pressure off Mike. Digger.
Correct. That's the right answer.
Mike knew it anyway.
Yeah. It's all sure.
Good one, guys. Digger is a classic. Number five is for Mike and Ravi. A secret agent and highly trained assassin, which Killer Instinct character kills you by flashing her unmentionables?
Whoa.
It's sort of a fatality in there.
Joe's paused this moment many times, isn't it?
I've got it paused right now.
Can you have both hands on the table, Joe?
Katrina?
Katrina, that's the wrong answer.
I just thought of a random kind of cool lady sounding name.
I'll pass it over to Joe and Dan.
It is. I don't want to mess this up. I can see her in my head right now.
I bet you can.
You see her in your head every night. Apparently, Joe.
Just pull the duvet up, Joe. Close your eyes.
10 seconds.
Timer, please, Ollie.
Oh, I want to. What's it? She's green. What's her name?
Yep, she's green.
Saberwolf.
I would want to know what Saberwolf's unmentionables look like. That would
very
be interesting.
Very furry. Very furry.
Oh.
it's a family show. Natural.
I know what it is as well. So it's just got to me. I won't take the point, but it's Black Orchid, isn't it?
Go on, tell me. It's Orchid, yet, or Black Orchid, yeah. That's the right answer.
Sorry. But I gave you Saberwolf.
Oh dear, close one. Anyway, so question number six is for Joe and Dan. In what year did both the animated and live action Street Fighter movies come out?
Oh.
I think this is my only year question of the quiz.
I've got a feeling. I think it might be.
Send it me. I don't think it is, man.
You sounded very passionate.
You think it's later or earlier?
I think it's a year later, I'm sure it is.
Okay, yeah, you might be right.
I think I should give you 10 seconds now.
Yes. Okay. Put the timer.
1994.
Oh, that is correct.
Well done.
Well done. Right, on to question number seven for Mike and Ravi. I like this question. On the cover for Micro Machines, what are the cars racing on? This is a level from the game.
Yeah, I think tablecloth.
Ooh, tablecloth. I'm gonna let them be more specific.
Yeah, give me a more specific answer than that.
Dining table,
kitchen table,
isn't
it?
No, kitchen table. It is a cloth,
not.
But no.
I'll pass it over to Joe. And
dishwashing
Dan.
Cloth.
What do you think, Joe? I think.
Well, I thought it was what they said.
Okay, I can picture it in my mind. It might be wrong. I don't think I actually had the box for the game back in the day.
Well, I thought it was a kitchen table, but should we go with what you said?
Okay, sure. Well, okay. All right, if I'm wrong now, then... okay, pool table.
It's pool table right is right. I thought you were going to get it wrong, then.
I thought it was what Ravi said.
Yeah, the kitchen table. Yeah, I remember seeing screenshots of that. Yeah, it's definitely
pool table. Yeah. I think it's the same on every version of the game as well, not just Amiga. On to question eight for Joe and Dan. Well, you get another one, similar question. On the front cover for the original Zool, what is written on the bottom of his shoes?
God. Written on his shoes.
He's kicking towards the screen.
Yeah, I'm going to guess that as well, Joe. Is it the Chupa Chups?
Oh, nice try, but no, it's not. I'll pass that over to Mike and Ravi.
You want to do it then?
No, it's a bit of a sly question. The answer is actually Zool. He has his name.
Just in case he loses them at the gym, yeah.
Andy, like on Toy Story.
Yeah, okay, right. Let's move on to question number nine for Mike and Ravi. In Rampage, players take control of a trio of gigantic monsters Who developed it? Just the company name?
Rampage.
Rampage.
I'm not sure.
I'm going to say...
This would be... Is it an arcade manufacturer? Is it a coin-op manufacturer?
Yes, it is, but I'm also going to give you 10 seconds left.
Yes.
I don't know.
Data East?
No, it's not the right answer. Not Data East. I'll pass it over.
Should go mine, Joe?
Joe and Dan.
We'll go with yours, Dan.
Okay. Midway?
Yes, that's the right answer.
Oh, God damn.
Midway.
the arcade didn't give it away.
I think at the time they were known as Bally Midway, yeah, I think. Right. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, right.
I think we've had the developer on the podcast, which we probably should.
Yes, Brian Collin, isn't it? Yeah.
Oh,
cool. Dear.
Right, okay, so this is the final question for this round. Number 10 for Joe and Dan. What was the last game? Sorry, it was the last game to be released for the Amiga A500. Finish this title. The Aquatic Games starring...
James Pond?
We're going to need the full title, is that right?
There's more to it than that.
And the... Oh, James Pond and the... Is it the Aquatic All-Stars or something?
No. I'm going to have to... Do you think I should pass it over?
I think we'll pass that over.
Yeah, I'm going to pass it over to Mike and Ravi.
I know this because I'm a James Pond fan.
he was close.
The Aquatic Games... James Pond and the Aquabats, I think that was it.
Yes, that
I nearly
correct.
Said that as well.
Very good.
I put in brackets as well the Super Aquatic Games starring Aquabats because it's known as that in some.
And there's
regions.
A good ska band called the Aquabats, actually, if you ever heard it.
You learn a new thing every day on this podcast. Well, that was a very tight round.
Good.
But Ravi and Mike are still the Squirtles on 26, but the Blastoise are Dan and Joe on 38.
Oh, dear. We're
okay. We're moving into the penultimate round, which means it's my round and it's a new one. This round 8 is called Control Freak. See what I did there? Because I am going to describe a game controller. And you need to try and get it from just my description.
And this is definitely not revenge for all those questions I've done about controllers over the years.
What I need to clarify is I'm not going to ask you to count any buttons, is that I want the game. So it's not, they're not going to be generic ones you know, a console. They're all games. Okay. So we're looking, the answer for each of them is a specific game.
So what, you're describing the controller from a game?
A custom controller
trust
for a game.
Me.
Oh,
trust
a custom.
Me, I'm a doctor.
Okay, yeah.
So it's easy peasy, right?
I think it is, but then I set the question, so they would be easy for me, okay? So bloody I am hell. Going to give you as before, you can pass, and I will move on to the next one, and we can even, if you've got any time at the end, you can even
who's first?
To it. So, for me, it's always...
Because I'm trying to get my head around this.
Yeah, okay. So it'd be easy, you'll see. Okay, so I'm going to describe the controls. You've just got to tell me the game.
Okay.
Okay, so wait for it now, okay? In fact, to give him a bit of a chance, I would like you to start the clock when I finished the first set of clues.
Okie dokie.
Right? Okay, give you a bit more time, okay? So here we go, okay? So this is an arcade game. It has 5 buttons, rotate left, rotate right, thrust, fire, and hyperspace. Start the clock.
Asteroids.
It is right. It's a console control pad. It has 40 buttons, 2 joysticks, a throttle handle, a radio channel, an eject button, and 3
foot
pedals.
What's it called? It's on the Xbox, Dan. Oh, where you play the big mech robot
just
thing.
Just say it.
Just say it.
I can't say
no,
it
is. I can't think of the...
No, close. You can keep going. No, do you want to pass?
Pass, yeah, pass.
Okay, the next one's an arcade game. It has 4 joysticks. Each one has 3 buttons marked shoot and block, pass and steal, and turbo. Arcade game, 4 players. Shoot.
Pass.
And block. Pass. That's one of the buttons. Pass. Okay. The fourth thing, it's a control panel. It's mainly white. There are no visible buttons. It's about 60 centimetres by 40 centimetres. It's a rectangular with curved corners. It kind of looks like something you might be able to put on the floor.
U-Force.
Something you could put on the floor. Maybe you could even then stand on it.
The Wii Fit.
I'm up.
Give them We Fit.
Okay. We did abysmal there.
There's no bonus ones for this one, I'm afraid. Can I just say the one that you clearly knew but couldn't quite say it? Steel Battalion.
Of course it was. Steel Battalion.
Okay. So you've got 2 points there. I am just intrigued as I put this
What's
round
the
together.
What's the four joystick one?
Good point. It's NBA Jam.
Or NBA Jam Turbo. But I wasn't sure if you meant like you play them all at once. I was like, who's playing this? A bloody octopus.
I said it was an arcade game, and actually an octopus could play it. That would be good, actually. Maybe that's an unlockable character that we don't know about. Maybe that's it. Can I just say, I was intrigued that in researching this, 40 million Wii Fits have sold with Wii Fit and Wii Fit Plus. So I'm just thinking there's a lot of balance boards under beds there. There's got to be some kind of art project to be done about that.
Or in cash converters if you go in there.
They use them as currency then. Okay, so now we're over to team two. So Ravi and Mike, okay? And same deal, I will read out the first clue and then ask Ollie to start the clock. Okay, are we ready? Here we go. Okay, it's an arcade game. It has a joystick which moves up and down. Then it has 5 buttons: thrust, reverse, fire, smart bomb, and hyperspace. Press start.
Scramble.
Nope. The hyperspace.
Drop zone.
Defender.
Nope. Correct. It's a console control pad. It has 3 buttons: a crossfader, an effect
DJ
dial,
Hero.
And a rope. Correct. It's an arcade game. It has 2 joysticks. One marked move and each well
flat
has, sorry it has what the other buttons marked flap, so it's a joystick, two joysticks and they've got flap next to each of them. Arcade game. Okay, it's a console control pad. It's great. It's got an analog stick in the middle. It's got 5 buttons and a reel that you could turn.
I'm saying about fishing.
Correct. It's an arcade game. It's got a joystick, 2 buttons, and both are marked pepper.
Pass.
Okay, so it's that other one. It's a flap, a joystick and flap. Think of a game that you would flap and fly. It's an arcade game from 1982.
Joust.
Correct. The other one was Pepper.
Time is up.
Okay, we got a few better than us
there, I think.
Got jousting though.
You did, yeah. You might put Pepper on a burger.
I was thinking time. Peppa Pig for something.
Yes, that well-known arcade game, Peppa Pig. Yes,
that's it. Right. Nowadays.
Right. Okay. Can I say? Well done there. They got 4 there. So at the end of that round, can I just say well done, Ravi and Michael did get 4, where Joe and Dan and Joe got 2. However, overall, as we approach the finishing line, in pole position is Dan and Joe with 40, and risking burnout are Ravi and Mike with 30. Now, this is technically, you could still, if you get all of these, this is still possible.
Okay.
This is still
possible. If we get them all wrong and they get them all right, they could win.
Yeah.
It will be amazing.
What's the chances?
That would be, what a comeback this would be. Okay? Amazing.
Right, so we are moving on to the final round of the quiz.
Name every lemming.
Howie, Bob, Fred, Harry.
Yeah, the DMA round.
Round number 9. This round is called Gaming Knowledge. It's just general questions about video games. Question number 1 is for Mike and Ravi. In Paper Mario: The Thousand Year Door, who kidnaps Peach?
I'll just have to say Bowser.
Yeah.
Bowser is the wrong answer.
Go on, Joe.
Oh, dear. I'll pass it over to Joe and Dan.
I think it's the little wizard guy, but I can't remember his name. Knap? Something like that?
No. I'm afraid they are called... they're called the X-Nauts. Pretty difficult question, to be fair.
Hard,
yeah. Okay, let's move on to question number 2 for Joe and Dan. Mortal Kombat Mythologies was a spin-off series that died on the vine. Which character did you play as?
Yeah, Sub-Zero.
That's right. It sounds like you're a big fan.
And as soon as you said Mythologies, I messaged Sub-Zero to Dan.
I know, because Joe paid an extortionate amount for it, and it's a terrible game recently. Didn't it?
We don't talk about that.
It's a very difficult game as well. Okay, question number 3 for Mike and Ravi. On the cabinet and the title screen, which letter is reversed in the original Tetris in the logo?
The R.
The R.
That's right. It is
well
R.
Done.
Well done.
Copying Toys R Us.
Oh, yeah, that's a good point. Question number four for Joe and Dan. Name the sequel to Arkanoid Revenge of Doe.
No, I don't know. Pass.
Arkanoid 2.
Yeah, I was going to say Arkanoid 2.
That was a good guess.
Oh, okay, yeah, no, yeah, it's a good guess, but no, it's not right. I'm afraid I'll pass it over to Mike and Ravi.
I want to give them an extra clue. It's a terrible pun.
I love the title of this game.
It is a good title, but it's a terrible pun.
So yeah, I passed it over.
Arkanoid 2. Arkanoid 3?
Just said that.
He said two.
Oh, he's gone for three.
No, I'm afraid the answer was Arkanoid. Do it again.
Oh god, that's good.
That's why it didn't do well.
Yeah.
Don't buy it.
Question number five for Mike and Ravi. Revolution X is a gun game developed by Midway and released in arcades in 1994. It is themed around which band? Musical band.
Jeez.
Yeah, Revolution X.
Would you say that?
Oh, it's definitely a rock band, yeah.
Stop giving them clues!
DL.
Well, I think. I wonder if they get it this way.
Whitesnake?
Oh, Whitesnake, no. That's the wrong answer.
Go on, Jez, got it.
Over.
Aerosmith.
That's right, Aerosmith.
Well done.
What a weird game.
That's mad, Aerosmith from the game.
Yeah. I know, right? The plastered all over it. It's very strange.
Brian May and Rise of the Robots.
I think it's about as good as Rise of the Robots.
Yeah,
that's
true.
That's impossible, clearly.
Yeah.
No, it's actually
Warren Davis from Cuba wrote that game, but he doesn't like to talk about it.
On to question number six for Joe and Dan. You play as Chuck Rock in the original game. But who do you play as in Chuck Rock 2?
Son of Chuck.
That is correct.
Yes,
he is the
well
son
done.
Of Chuck. On to question number 7 for Mike and Ravi. Which classic 1981 arcade game has the same name as a play by William Shakespeare?
Tempest.
That's the right answer.
Well done.
Finally, a bit
I studied
of culture.
Theater.
Hold on.
Don't get much culture on this podcast normally.
Yeah, wow. Only three questions to go for the whole quiz. Number 8 for Joe and Dan. What body part does the main recurring boss in the Super Smash Brothers series resemble?
A hand.
That's the right answer.
You don't want to know my answer.
Oh. Well, hang on.
Oh dear, that's the X-rated version of the game. Question number 9 for Mike and Ravi. Mr. Do is an arcade game from 1982. A type of fruit can be collected to complete levels. Are these cherries or strawberries?
Mike says cherry.
That well is done. Correct.
Hey. Well done. I was like, if they get that wrong, then we should be able to get that right, surely.
50-50, yeah.
He didn't lose his cherry.
Not like the we need the points questions. Anyway, just so.
Yeah, the last two questions are 50-50, basically. This is the final question of the quiz. Number 10 for Joe and Dan. Mega Man originates from Japan, where it's known as Rock Man. This is because the series has references to music. True or false?
Go on, get it wrong.
That's false.
It's wrong, so we can...
Go on, guys, have a guess.
What do you think, Ollie?
Yeah, Mike and Ravi.
Yeah, true.
Take your time.
It is true.
Amazing job. Yeah. Well done.
There's lots of references to music, including the fact that his sister is called Roll.
Okay.
And then in Mega Man 8, the bad guy's called Bass, isn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, my bad.
Should have got it, though.
Should have got it.
Okay.
No, I wanted to give it to them.
Yeah.
How generous.
Sympathy
points.
Petty
points.
Okay, so at the end of this year's Retroact quiz, the Mushroom Cup goes to Ravi and Mike on 34,
shocker.
But the special cup goes to Dan and Joe on 44. Well done!
Thank you, Mike, for joining me, and, you know, we've had a gag.
I would like to point out that if it wasn't for the incredible performance on the single word campaign round, where Dan's clue was people and they managed to get the sim.
10 points
ago. It would have been a lot closer.
10 points ago, yeah, that one.
Absolutely, yeah. I would just like to say thank you very much for having us both back
on
the quiz. I don't know whether we're allowed to be somehow behind or in front of the mic next year, but it's always a pleasure, and it's great to see how well the podcast
is doing.
Yeah, I think we need to somehow break up this Joe and Dan dominance.
yeah.
I thought the questions were great. I love the only connect round as well. That was really smart.
Maybe that can come back as well. So, it's been an absolute pleasure. Can I also say, well done for putting Nottingham on the gaming mac through the Retro Hour. Very proud. As someone who writes the Nottingham Post games column for 20 years, you make us all very proud being local boys. So really appreciate it. And Ravi, I believe you're bringing screenplay back as well, aren't you?
Yes. I'm working on a video game festival and like little events with Paul Drury, so we'll have some more info
is that
on that.
Right? Okay. Maybe we could get Mike and Dan and Joe to be involved.
The plugs in, boys.
Okay.
Yeah, listen,
thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you very much, Paul and Ollie. Yeah, we really enjoy having you on. It's definitely a Christmas tradition catching up with you guys. So commiserations, Ravi. I know you've got a plan already for next year, I can tell.
I'm just keeping tradition.
Yeah.
I'm maintaining it.
And can we just take a moment as well to say a very Merry Christmas and a big thank you to our lovely listeners as well, as this is our final podcast of 2022. What a year it's been. So from all of us, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Happy holidays.
It's Christmas.